Good evening, Philadelphia! Well, it's great to be back. We are going to have a party here in this place tonight. Oh, yeah. We're going to give you some old songs, some new songs, some in-between songs. We're going to have some fun.
Give you.
online.
You're welcome.
It's so cool. I'm just going to take a moment here just to drink it all in for myself, okay? Electronic. Here we go. It's called Temporary Secretary.
Thank you.
Thank you. How you doing?
Put their foot down.
Oh yeah. Well, thank you, Philadelphia. Okay, we'd like to do a song now. This is one that I wrote for my wife, Nancy. And Nancy's here tonight. With a dance. And this one's for you, Nance. If it rained, we didn't care. She said that someday soon the sun was gonna shine, and she was right. This love of mine, my Valentine. As days and nights me by, I tell myself that I was waiting for a sign, that she appeared, a love so fine, for a Valentine. I will never let a day go by without remembering the reasons why. She makes me certain that I can fly. So I do, without a care. I know that someday soon the sun is gonna shine, and she'll be there. It's the love of mine, my Valentine. This next one here is for the Wings fans. Oh,
Maybe I'm amazed at the way you love me all the time. Or maybe I'm afraid of the way I love you. Maybe I'm amazed at the way you.
Okay, now you see, people bring along these signs, okay? And great, we love that you bring along these signs. But what happens is, you're trying to actually concentrate on your chords and on the words and on singing the song, right? And your mind says, don't read the signs. Yeah? Well, you do. The other part of your mind says, yeah, read them, it doesn't matter, you know. There's one here. Concert number 25. Spending our kids' inheritance. Only thing is, though, if I get it all wrong, I'm going to blame the signs, okay? So we're going to take you back now, a long time ago. And this is going back to the days before the Beatles, to the very first recording we ever made. It was a little amateur recording we made up in Liverpool, and it cost us £5 to make. And the song we did then is the song we're going to sing for you now, the very first one. Spite of all the danger, spite of all that may be, oh, I'll do anything for you, anything you want me to. Spite of all the heartache that you may cause me. To spite of all the danger, spite of all that they need, I'll do anything for you, anything you want me to. Say to me, how does a song start? How do you write a song? You know, how does it come about? And there's loads of answers. You know, it can be from a title that you like and you work around that, or it can be from a melody, or sometimes it's just from a musical phrase. And this next song started with this musical phrase. Song to the great Beatles producer Sir George Martin. He's a fantastic guy, really lovely man, and without him there wouldn't be any Beatles records. In fact, with that song that was one of the first we recorded in Abbey Road Studios, came down there and John always used to sing the line "Love me do," and then he would play the harmonica, so go "Love me do, wow." But George Martin said, "Paul, could you possibly sing the 'Love me do' line, because then John can 'Love me do' and John can go on the bar 'Love me wah.'" So he asked, he's suddenly in the middle of the session, he says, "Could you sing that?" And I got like so nervous, I go, "Oh yeah, sure." And I can still hear it on the record today if I listen to "Love Me Do." Listen, we love you, George. Too. I love her. thank you. Thank you. Oh, man. Well, nice evening. Thank you. Way back in the 60s, there were a lot of troubles going on, particularly in the southern states in America, over civil rights. And we would hear about this on the news. And I wanted to try and write a song that if it ever got back to the people in places like Arkansas, Alabama, Little Rock and that, that if it ever got back to them, it might just give them a little bit of hope while they were going through their struggles. That's the 60s. Blackbirds singing in the dead of night. Take these broken wings and learn to fly all your life. You were only waiting for this moment to arrive. Blackbirds singing in the dead of night. Take these sunken eyes and learn to see all your life. You were only waiting for this moment to be free. Blackbirds fly. Blackbirds singing in the dead of night. Take these broken wings and learn to fly all your life. You were only waiting for this moment to arise. Blackbirds. Blackbirds singing in the dead of night. Take these sunken eyes and learn to see all your life. You were only waiting for this moment to be free. You were only waiting for this moment to be free. You were only waiting for this moment to be free. One of the things I love about having written that song is I go around the world and often people come up to me and say, hey man, you know, I tried to learn that song Blackbird on guitar, you know. How many people here tried to learn Blackbird on guitar? And you all got it wrong. No, not really. Anyway, so one of the things I say in these shows is that sometimes you want to say something nice to someone, but you think, I'll put it off. I'll tell them in a couple of days, maybe next week or something. I can do it then. Then suddenly it can be too late. And it's the case with this next song. I wrote this after my dear friend John passed away. Let's hear it for John. Anyway, so as I say, this is song I wrote after he passed away, and this is in the form of a conversation that we never got to have. And if I said, I really knew you well, what would your answer be? If you were here today, ooh, here today. Well, knowing you, you'd probably laugh and say that we were worlds apart. If you were here today, ooh, here today. But as for me, I still remember how it was before, and I am holding back the tears no more. I suppose that you could say that we were playing hard to get. We didn't understand a thing, but we could always sing. And what about the night we cried? About the night? Cause there wasn't any reason left to keep it all inside. We never understood a word, but you were always there with a smile. And if I say I really loved you and was glad you came along, then you were here today. Ooh, for you were in my song. So there you are, if you want to say something nice to someone, get it said quick.
There you go.
I love you too, man.
This song is off our most recent album. The album's called New. The song is called Queenie Eye.
Turn it out.
Thank you. Okay. This one is the... So you got the ball. Alright. It's the title song of the most recent album. This one is called New.
Is head in a cloud, the mountain.
Thank you, good people. Song that we ever recorded, and now we'd like to play you the latest one, which was just from last year. And if you want to sing along, I believe the words come on the screen.
Maybe.
tonight are actually from Philadelphia. Now, how many people are not from Philadelphia but are from Pennsylvania? And how many people are not from Philadelphia, not from Pennsylvania, but from somewhere else? On behalf of the tourist board, we welcome you. You know, as I was saying before, some of you people say how the songs come about, and this next song is off the Sgt. Pepper's Lonely Hearts Club Band album. And this one was I was over at John's house, and over at John's house, and we were wondering what we were going to write that afternoon, looking for something to write, and he had this poster on his wall. An old circus poster. So we were looking at it, and it said, "Being for the benefit of Mr. Kite, the Hendersons, Pablo Fanker's Fair, Henry the Horse." So we kind of just wrote it down.
Mr. K will chance the world.
on Saturday in Bishop's Gate. The Hennessons will dance and sing, Mr. Kite rides through the rain, don't be late. Mrs. Kelly, she's sure the public their production will be sailing on. But of course, Henry Law's dancing for Somerset, he'll undertake on solid ground. And it feels amazing preparation. A splendid time is guaranteed for all. But tonight, Mr. Kite is coming away. George Harrison was a really good ukulele player. Did you know that? Let's hear from Georgie. Yeah. Sane's a great ukulele player, and I was around at his house, and we both had ukuleles, and we're sitting around and we're jamming on them. And I said to him, I've learned one of your songs on the ukulele, you know? So we played it together that day, and we'd like to play it for you now. Something in the way she moves, I try and be like no other lover. Something in the way she moves me, I don't want to leave her now. You know I believe her now. Somewhere in a smile she knows that I don't need no other lover. Something in a style that shows me I don't want to leave her now. You know I believe her now. You're asking me, will my love grow? Well, I don't know. I don't know. No, no. You stick around now, and it may show Thank you, and thank you, George, for writing that beautiful song. Okay, and this next song, I know you've been singing along, but in the middle there's a bit where I will go, now you, and you will sing most beautifully for me. Are you ready for that? Are you ready?
Oh, up on a screaming, you asshole.
Back in the USSR, yeah. And I tell the story that we had always wanted to go to Russia, just if for nothing else, just to play on that song, you know. And we got an invitation quite a few years back now to go and play in Red Square in Moscow, and we were actually the first rock and roll band to play in Red Square. Time, you know. It was a nice concert. We thought we played good. The audience was great. The Ruskies really liked to rock, and we had a good time. But one of the interesting things about it was backstage, there was a lot of members of the Russian government, because you know it was Red Square and it was the Kremlin was right there, and so a lot of these guys backstage. And somebody said to me, pointed out a guy, they said, that guy is the defense minister of Russia. So I'm going, defense minister, that's a pretty big job, you know. Anyway, he comes up to me, he says, Paul, first record I ever bought was Love Me Do. It's true. And then this other big guy comes up and someone said, yeah, he's in the government too. He comes up, he says, we learned to speak English from Beatles records. He looks me right in the eye. He says, hello, goodbye. So close. It's true. It's true, honest. In times of trouble, Mother Mary comes to me, speaking words of wisdom, let it be. And in my hour of darkness, she is standing right in front of me, speaking words of wisdom, let it be. Let it be.
Let it be. Let it be. Let it be.
Thank you, thank you for the lights. Beautiful, let it be. There will be an answer. Thank you.
good.
Thank you, you're a fantastic crowd tonight. Thank you so much. Yesterday, all my troubles seemed so far away. Now it looks as though they're here to stay. Oh, I in yesterday, suddenly I'm not half the man I used to be. There's a shadow hanging over me. Oh, yesterday, can suddenly, why she had to go, I don't know. She would. I said something wrong. Now I long for yesterday. Yesterday, love was such an easy game to play. Now I need a place to hide away. Oh, I believe. Yesterday, why she had to go, I don't know, she wouldn't say. I said something wrong, now I long for yesterday. Yesterday, love was such an easy. To hide away. Oh, I believe yesterday. Says you want to keep rocking. Okay. Let's do it. Yeah, I'm Life with Wings. One, two. We'll be right back. Funny say yeah! Funny say okay!
Okay!
Funny say all right!
All right!
Funny say yeah! Somebody out of the audience with the signs. So I want to see who we got tonight. Who we got, Brian? Let's see. Okay. Ha ha! All right. Concert 25, spending our kids' inheritance. Where are you from, Kathy?
Easton, Pennsylvania.
So you're like defrauding the kids, basically.
No, pretty much. Yeah. But that's okay, because we're all coming to see you August in the New York. I can't even think where.
In the New York.
I'm taking them next time.
You're not nervous, are you, at all, Kathy?
Nope. Perfectly fine.
She's rocking. Well, kids, anyway, look, kids, it's not my fault, right? She spent it. I love you. Uncle Paul says hi. Can I propose? He said he'll marry me if he meets you, Paul. Can he propose? I suppose he can propose. All right, what's your name?
Dylan Berwick.
Where are you from?
Philadelphia.
What's your name?
Marissa Gray.
Where are you from, Marissa?
Also from Philadelphia.
Philadelphia! So this is real, you really want to do this, do you? I don't mind, it's nothing to do with me. Okay, so, down on your knee, boy.
Yeah!
All right. Happy birthday. Okay, listen, we've had an incredible time here tonight, but we do have to go. Yeah.
Yeah.
And what is more, you have to go.
Yeah.
Hey, but listen, to bring you a big show like this, we got a lot of amazing people we want to thank. We got to thank guys out on the sound, on the lights, on the video screens, and all the equipment, the guitars, the drums, the piano, and all the stuff we got here. And the guys who rigged this all, do the catering, and the truckers who bring it to us. So, why don't you give the best hand for the greatest crew on the planet? I want to give a special thank you to this fantastic band of mine. Andy, Rixie, Brian and Rusty. Thank you, Wix. But as we always say, we mainly want to thank you, everyone here tonight, for coming along. Thank you. You've been brilliant. We love you. Once there was a way to get back home. Once there was a way to get back home. Now see, little darling, do not cry, but I will see. See you, little lullaby.
We'll see you next time.